All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back Thursday. Hope you guys had a great week thus far. We're running it back, Drummond International. Thank you for tuning in. Make sure you share this with your friends, share this with loved ones. Leave us some comments. Let us know what you think, your thoughts on what we're sharing. That's always helpful and encouraging to hear from you. So again, thank you for tuning in today, taking the time. I have back this lovely couple who was on Monday. You know, I'm excited to have them on. On Monday, we had them share about their marriage and their experiences and the foundation of their marriage, which is their faith in God. And it was really a great time to hear them expound on how they do ministry together. You know, so it was a great time. And guys, you want to greet the people? We might have some new viewers on, so you want to greet everybody?
Absolutely, yes. Hello, everyone. My name is Melissa Burnett, and I am the president for the Left Out Organization Program, also known as LOOP, for Boys and Girls.
Yeah, my name is Anthony Burnett, and also I am the CEO and founder of the LOOP BNG, and we're here on this lovely show here, and we just want you to tune in and share.
Yeah. So again, you know, I'm thankful to have you guys on. Let's get right into it today. Let's begin by just speaking about your ministry, because I know you guys, you're on the front lines when it comes to inner city ministry with the youth, and you've been doing that for a number of years. I know you have your Sunday service virtually, which I've watched a couple times every week. So why don't you guys share with the viewers some of the things you're doing, you know, the communities and stuff like that, and then we'll spin it off from there.
What we were doing pre-COVID, we, as you mentioned, had our ministry. Pre-COVID, we were actually going into the William Halliday Homes community room, and we would hold our service there, mm-hmm. and youth would come over, and sometimes adults, and we would have a Bible lesson with them, and then after every Bible lesson on Sundays, we also feed them. We understand that there are a lot of food deserts, and that's one of the things that Pastor Anthony felt was very important early on with the ministry, is that we always need to have some sustenance for them, not just for their heart and mind with the word, but also nourishment for their stomach. So that's one thing that we have consistently been doing. Fast forward now to COVID, we had to move everything online. So we're doing the ministry online every Sunday and throughout the week, also going into some of the areas and distributing food just to make sure that the families do have what they need. Also connecting them to other resources throughout the community, so at any given time, they're able to access food as well.
Okay.
So and then with that, every third week, we would have a big dinner.
Okay.
And we'll bring in all the families, all the families would come in. If they wanted to fix a side, something, like a side or whatever, they could, we would usually have everything there for them. Mm-hmm. But we wanted them to be, part of the whole thing. So they would either bring pies, cakes, or whatever, mm-hmm. Cookies, whatever they felt obligated to bring or whatnot. And we would have a good time, holidays, and we actually been over there for at least 12
oh, really?
Years.
Oh, okay.
We've been in that area, and we also had South Harrisburg mm-hmm. at one given time that we would run at the same time mm-hmm. from 11 to 2. And it was beautiful. We had some, people who, turned their life around. We mm-hmm. had people who came and got saved, and just different things happen in different events and took place, and we are looking forward to it. Like mm-hmm. you said, pre-COVID mm-hmm. situations now is just kind of really tight.
Right.
So we're trying to see what's going to happen next, mm-hmm. but we're asking God to just open it up and open it back up so that we can minister to the people.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And that's our main goal, is to win souls and just love on souls. And everything is free. Nothing is no charge. If people wanted to give a donation, that's fine. Mm-hmm. We don't we don't force them to do it, you know, but if they feel obligated and they feel that it's a heartfelt thing to do, then we do that. We do train that too, though. Mm. We do share that type of training to, you know, that to just give, mm-hmm. you know, because God is a giver, mm-hmm. and we know that God says, you know, as I freely give unto you, mm-hmm. so shall you freely give.
Yes.
So we want to, you know, we want to definitely do that. So
right. So also too, I noticed you guys have a back to school drive or something. I noticed something recently. I know you do it every year, but mm-hmm. can you share about that as far as the youth and giving back? I think it's about backpacks or whatever, but right. you guys expound on that. And that was just recent, like right. a week ago or something, right. a few days ago.
So we have an annual back to school event, and typically it's held outside and it's open to the community. Last year we had over 350 youth that registered. Once they came to the table, we had everybody sign in just so we could get a good idea of how many participated, so we would know for the next year how to supply and everything we needed. Within that event, we had barber there doing on-site haircuts for the youth. We had hairstylists there for the female youth. We had face painters. We had lots of free food. We had entertainment, music. Harrisburg Faulkner Subaru dispensed and provided all the book bags full of all the back-to-school supplies. Mm-hmm. So we had several vendors and volunteers there to help with the event itself, and it was truly amazing. That was the largest one to date. Wow. As I mentioned, over 350 youth registered and received supplies for that event. So now with COVID, we had to shift and rethink how we would be able to safely get supplies to the students. We knew that we couldn't have that large amount of people mm-hmm. in one area. So what we decided to do was, instead of buying the book bags with the school supplies, we decided we would do two polo shirts for each of the youth. So when they do go into school, because Harrisburg School District has a uniform as far as the polo shirts they mm-hmm. need to wear and the khaki pants. And just talking with some parents, in previous years, that's one of the things they struggled with. They didn't always have enough money to mm-hmm. obtain uniforms. So again, we decided to go with two polo shirts in each of the book bags. All the youth received a book bag with a Loop logo on it. Mm-hmm. They received face masks, which is washable and reusable. Mm-hmm. They contain two filters within it. Excuse me. Hand sanitizers. Disinfectant wipes, chapstick, just as many of the things that we could think of to put in the book bag to mm-hmm. help keep them safe, because we knew at some point they would be going into the school, but even when they're home, you still want to, you know, wipe down doorknobs mm-hmm. and, you know, facial tissue in there if you need to blow your nose or sneeze, and then hand sanitizer. So we also had to break up the events, and we had one day that we had the events at four different locations. So we started at LHAC on Dairy Street with the mm-hmm. Latino community, and we dispensed their bags to them. We had reached out to LHAC, and they had registered some families in advance, so mm-hmm. we knew the shirt sizes, and we had, you know, a specific amount of items that we would give to them. From there, we then went to the William Howard Day Homes down in the projects on Cameron Street. Mm-hmm. And again, we had some pre-registered families, so we dispensed the items there. We also went up to Emerald Street Playground mm-hmm. with the same, you know, idea, and dispensed the items to them. And then that Friday prior, we had HPAL, the Police mm-hmm. Athletic okay. League, right. their group. Yep. So again, just keeping in mind with the social distancing, we just broke it up like that, and we're able to provide the youth with things that they needed.
And we also want to connect the dots with other organizations, as she spoke of, LHAC, and then of course our Police Athletic League. We always want to, you know, reach out to other mm-hmm. organizations and you know, collaborate with them, and, mm-hmm. you know, so that we can just freely do the, you know, that communication thing, and just, you know, sharing, you know, what God has given us, the ability to do with other organizations as well.
And also Reverend Lyles with his 10 times ministry.
Yes.
He and his group were there with the back to school supplies as far as the notebooks, pens, pencils. He even gave out spaghetti dinner meals for them to have all the ingredients to cook spaghetti.
Right.
So that was absolutely beautiful. So they received everything, you know, that day, and that was just, you know, wonderful. And, you know, it was just amazing to see just everyone come together, you know, with those, you know, different organizations for that one common goal of serving the community.
Yeah, so partnership is really important.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
When you partner, collaborate, that way you're not an island unto yourself.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know, I heard someone say, we can accomplish more together than we do separate.
That's right. Absolutely.
You know, so, and I noticed, I have to be honest though, like, I'm always trying to speak truth and keep it real. Like, a lot of times there are people who shy away from partnerships. I don't know if you guys have noticed that, but I've noticed that personally.
Right.
There are times I reach out to certain people who may be doing the, or have a similar vision as I do or doing certain things. I reach out to them, hey, and I'm thinking to reach out to collaborate.
Sure.
I never get a call back. I never get a response. And sometimes people are against that because they see you as a competitor.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't know if you guys experienced that yet, but, you know, I felt that. And the thing is, we can accomplish so much more together.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? What do you guys think about that?
Well, one of the things is that dealing with that lately, even in with our training, you know, like, because we're always training in God's, you know, and allowing God to, you know, work through us to assess us to, you know, to the situation.
Mm-hmm.
And what we've actually come up with is that, you know, let's just be positive and continue to be positive to the things that you need to do.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe somehow or some way, they'll come around, and they'll start, you know, feeling like, oh, you know what, this ain't so bad after all.
Mm-hmm.
Because some people are very protective.
Yeah.
Like with, you know, if you have something that's grassroots and something that you built, and you want to make sure that you want to keep it that way.
Right.
So that way you get a little attached, and you don't delegate.
Yeah.
See, I had to do all that. I start delegating. I said, you know, this, and I had to realize this is not mine.
Right. Okay.
This is
that's
of
a
God.
Good point. Yeah.
You know what I mean? So sometimes people fear that.
Yeah.
It's one of the reasons why they don't want to get, you know, caught up with another organization, especially if that organization is really shining.
Well established.
They can swallow up their whole, their perception of things.
Right.
So you know, and we faced that many times, but, you know, like I said, in our studies, we always want to be careful to know that, you know what, this is God's.
Mm-hmm.
This is not ours. It's not us. We shouldn't, you know, try to be protective that way.
Yeah.
Share it. Let it go. You know, surrender. Again, surrender.
Yeah.
Surrender
but
again.
But you mentioned on Monday.
You know, surrender,
about
man.
That.
Yeah.
And in that, I believe if we all stay focused as to what our common goal is, it should never come down to this is mine or this is yours. This is for the community.
Right.
So even when we're asked to come and participate at different events and things, we always, you know, are mindful, you know, what do we wear? Because we don't want to necessarily show up and we're wearing our, you know, our shirts with our logos and this is someone else's event, you know, we're here to volunteer, what have you.
Right.
We're more than happy to, you know, put on their shirts or, you know, step back. We don't need the limelight. We're just here for the purpose of the community and for serving. So if we're all mindful about, you know, what it is that we're doing and if it's for the right reason, it should never come down to, you know, well, I want this to be all about my program, so make sure I'm highlighted, you know, and even though you're here, just, you know, stay back.
Yeah.
It should be about love. It should be about giving and just, you know, the community.
And that's a definitely good approach, you know. You guys have the right heart, you know. That's one thing I notice is it's all about the heart with you guys. And I know, like, if your heart is in the right place, there's nothing you can't accomplish.
That's right.
You know, but a lot of times people's heart in the wrong place, so therefore that's why they're not doing certain things, you know. And I want to say this too, even to the about connecting with people, and if you have your own thing, maybe some of you have your own ministry or your own business or so forth. I would say there. Timing is important too. So
that's
I'll
right.
say that, because sometimes if you are grassroots, maybe you need some time to develop and you sure. develop your own legs first right. to stand on. Absolutely. You know, right. so maybe you're in that stage and you know you just develop it and you're not ready to launch out and connect, and that's fine too. Mm-hmm. But I know some people are in that place, but they kind of shy away from it because of, you know. And to be honest, I noticed this in the African American community a lot.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
African American community. We don't work together like we right. should. And let's keep it real.
Mm-hmm. It's all about trust. Mm-hmm. And that's where we have a trust factor. Mm-hmm. You know, like when you get down to the individual personally, because that's who we are. We are who we are. As one person, mm-hmm. so you know, and that's what I was saying about being a brand. How,
yeah,
my, you know, working at Gannett Fleming for over mm-hmm. 20 years, it taught me how to be the brand, not just you know, get my license plate changed and get cards and make my brochures and just be about it, mm-hmm. but it also taught me in the brand to be respectful mm-hmm. and to trust, you know, in that brand. You gotta yeah. trust your brand. You gotta trust who you are
yeah.
to highlight your brand. Mm-hmm. You know, and again, it does take, it also comes to protecting your brand. Mm-hmm. You don't wanna just, you know, allow your brand to be, you know, tarnished
yeah.
with foolishness
yeah.
and stuff like that. So, you know, that's what made us today mm-hmm. because of these things, these qualities that, mm-hmm. you know, these skillful qualities that was, you know, just naturally, mm-hmm. Being take place and just giving it some thought,
right?
Because it's fear there. No yeah. fear, yeah. you know what I mean? It's
oh, yeah.
there.
Yes.
You just have to trust God mm-hmm. that oh, He nice. Will make it right. He will, yeah. you know. So that's where we at with that. And I'm telling you, you're right. So it's hard,
yeah,
at times. But when you focus on God and you say, hey, God said, my burden is light, my yoke is easy. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you gotta know these things. And it's just not saying it, it's believing it.
Right, right.
You know, so yeah. That's it. You know?
Yeah. Yeah. Let me ask you this. So, in light of that, you guys have a team of people you have on your staff. How do you, I don't know if you recruit or you just have people word of mouth. Because, you know, this is for the viewers too. We're in yeah. central Pennsylvania, as all of you know, yes. but I have people watching from right. all over. So how do you go about, you know, your volunteers, people in your program? How do you do that? You know, you look for certain type of people,
absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, right. we have a dedicated core staff that has been working with us for several years. They're truly committed. And one of the things, again, that we did early on was just speak to each of them as individuals to see, you know, where do you feel you could best, you know, provide and volunteer, you know, what area, because I'm not a coach. There are some things that I'll do sports wise, but I know that's not a strength of mine. Mm-hmm. So we took that approach with all of our staff, you know, where do you feel is, you know, your greatest strength and what you would like to do. So once we were able to do that, then everyone had their specific tasks. Okay, you're going to be the, you know, the activities coordinator, mm-hmm. you're going to be taking care of, you know, arts and crafts, you're going to be on the homework assistance and mm-hmm. tutoring, you know,
okay.
staff, mentoring, you know, all the different areas that we have. So we were able to just place everyone there. And then we're always looking for quality volunteers because we have so many youth in the program mm-hmm. when we are open that there's always room for additional staff. So what I said was quality, not qualified, because mm-hmm. you can be qualified on paper in so many ways,
that's
but you
point.
Don't have that quality.
Right. Yeah.
Our mm-hmm. youth are considered to be at-risk youth, so mm-hmm. they need a lot more hands-on. You certainly have to be patient. Mm-hmm. You have to be willing to not give up on them. And the majority of the things that they need consist of love, time, and commitment. Mm-hmm. It's not about, you know, I have a degree and I can come and, you know, teach them this skill or, you know, what have you. The children just want you to be real. Mm-hmm. They want to know that your heart's there for them, not for any accolades or because it looks good on your resume. So quality people are what we're always looking for. And there's so many components. You can come in as a recreational volunteer, you know, helping out with the different sports, again, with the different arts and crafts. You have a skill, you want to come in and show them how, you know, you're a barber and how do you cut hair. You're a chef, this is how you can cook. Just come in and do some hygiene, you know, classes. Just everyone has something that they can offer if that's something that their heart desires. And then also within that, of course, we vet everyone prior to coming on board. There's an interview process with the both of us. We have background checks. Okay. There's FBI, there's FBI. State, there's child abuse, the mandated reporter. You know, you get a whole orientation as if you were coming to, you know, actually be employed. Because these are children. They're very fragile. And we just, you know, aren't just going to have anyone just walking in without making sure that they're safe and that they would be the right fit for the program as well as to work with youth.
And then our board of directors, like I told you before, we have our board of directors, and they're just a full of, you know, vibrant spirit. And they're, you know, always seeking to what can we do? How much more can we do? Can we do more? You know, they're always trying to figure out ways to benefit the program, to assist the young people who may be at risk, you know, and causing, you know, maybe affecting their life or whatever.
Right.
But it's trickled down from the board of directors all the way to the field people. So it's a, like I said before, you know, and it's all about God. Everybody knows that it's all about God. It's a love thing, you know.
And then that's something to be thankful for in this day and age.
That's right.
To find quality, quality committed people who love God and willing to submit to the vision and link up, link arms. I mean, that's a rarity in today's in today's society. So I mean, but that's a reflection of you guys too. You know, they see something in you, they see your leadership, they see your love, they see your passion.
Know.
And so because of that, they're drawn to that, and then they're willing to do whatever it takes.
That's right.
You know, and I'm sure you've had people who you've had to weed out, you know.
Yes.
I'm sure that's a part of the process too.
It is.
You know, you gotta have them meetings where somebody isn't told the line or what they're supposed to do. And you know, that's the part of being a leader.
Absolutely.
You know, but I'm sure you guys are thankful for the team you have.
Very thankful.
Oh yeah.
You know, and you guys are moving
very
forward.
Blessed and fortunate to have them.
Yes.
But we do know that God is because of God. That, you know what I mean? And when I say that, I'm talking about the living God.
Yeah.
And, you know, the living God that lives in us.
Yeah.
That lives through us. Amen.
Amen.
So we don't want to, you know, spook nobody out or anything like that, because we keep mentioning God. But we know that it's the God in us.
Mm-hmm.
It's
yes.
the God in you. It's yes. the God in, you know, my wife. It's the God. It's the God that we seek in each other.
Yeah.
And that's the thing. You got to seek that, because God has said He's the living God.
Yeah.
He's real.
Right.
So we have to look for that God in each other.
Yeah.
And
that's
God,
a good point.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, that's a good point. Man, this is great, bro. I hope you guys enjoyed this as much as I did. You know, leave some comments. You know, say something if you got some encouragement to say. Definitely appreciate your comments. Let us know where you're watching from. Definitely appreciate that. This is a great couple here. And as you know, my goal is to always honor those who are doing great things in the community, in the world. I like to, you know, give a platform to some people who may not have a voice, you know, so because we need more honor in our society today. You know, everybody's thinking about themselves, but, you know, I think there needs to be more honor, because people are doing a lot of great things in our communities, not only in Central Pennsylvania, but around the world, and it's going unnoticed. You know, not that you guys are doing, you want to be noticed, and you're out to get a lot of attention, but I just felt in my heart to have them on, you know, so you guys can share some of the great things you're doing. So,
thank you so much.
Thank you guys for coming on. And we're going to partner. We'll get into that later. There's some things you guys will hear later. So just partnering together, speaking of that word, collaboration, we'll be doing some things together. So thank you again for tuning in. Make sure you share this. Don't forget to follow our page. Check out my website, JarmanIntl.com. Also our YouTube page as well. All right. Take care, and we'll see you next week.
Perfect.